Hello there. I've got a spare hour and a half or so this Sunday morning, other things to do later on in the day, but I thought I'd just pop down to the boat and get something underway so that I could tick something off on the list of DIY things to do. Nothing great big. I've brought a couple of screwdrivers with me, but I just wanted to get something done so that I feel that progress has started. The first good news is I haven't been to the boat for about 3 weeks. And there's been a lot of rain and it is completely dry in the centre cockpit area. So that does mean that whatever the leak is at the back, it's not so big that it's all gushing through here. There is, I notice, a tiny drop or two of water there, which suggests possibly condensation, I suppose, from the canopy. In fact, now I look up there, yes, look, there's condensation. That's not a surprise, so not worried about that. The question is, how soggy is it in there? The floor looks dry. The towel I put down underneath the can of Elsan Blue looks very soggy indeed, so let's wring that out. Yes, that is very soggy and there's a dead fly. But given that I haven't been here for 3 weeks and we've had a lot of rain, it's actually not that much. Well, that's the tally. I mean, it's not great, don't get me wrong, but it's not like the boat is flooding as such. Whether that water is dirty because it's canal water or because the towel it was soaked up in is dirty, I don't know. So I've brought a fresh towel. Here it is, nice white cream one. So we should definitely see if the water is dirty or whatever. But also, as suggested by several viewers and my mother, I've bought a small thing of food colouring, which I'm going to pop into the outboard motor well. And then obviously if that food colouring comes through, we'll know that that's where the water is leaking through from. Or at least partially, perhaps, leaking through from. And if the water comes through and it's just mucky water, then we know it is, in fact, coming through from some crack in the hull. The towel is placed. In fact, I'll weight it down with the bottle of Elsan Blue again. There we go, that's not going anywhere. And now I'll tip some of the food colouring out here into this outboard motor well. There's not a lot of water in there, but... And it is only food colouring, so if it gets into the canal, it's not a problem. It's not toxic or anything. Right, when I come back next time, we'll see what colour the incoming water is. Just before I crack on, a reminder that the Boat Life Show is imminent. It is impending and almost upon us. Runs from Thursday the 15th to Sunday the 18th of February at the NEC in Birmingham. And I am an ambassador for the show, and that means I get to give a talk at the show. Well, not so much a talk, it's a chat. There is a live stage area with comfy armchairs on it, and a host of that area will be chatting with me about all things canals and narrowboating. And the time and date for that talk has now been confirmed. It's the Friday, the 16th at 1:45 p.m. There is an audience area, obviously, where you can sit and listen to us chatting and perhaps even throw some questions our way as well. So if you're able to come along, that'd be absolutely marvellous. You can get your tickets from the boatlifeevents.com website. There's a link in the video description below, and if you use the code CruisingTheCut, there is a discount on the tickets as well. Now, the other thing to mention, of course, as we get closer to the start date of the show, is that the exhibitor list is becoming firmed up. So, again, look at boatlifeevents.com for the latest exhibitor list and the show plan layout if there's someone that you particularly wish to speak to. A reminder that it is not just an inland waterway show, it is a boat show. It's got everything boating. It's got stand-up paddleboards, dinghies, ribs, trailers, outboard motors, coastal cruisers, a bit of everything, but they have a dedicated inland waterways section. And for example, I can't go through all of them, but for example, boat builders there include Oakham's. If you watch Narrowboat Life Unlocked, you know Oakham's built their narrowboat. Lakeland Leisure, JF Boat Building, Swan Boat Builders, Collingwood, who've been making canal boats for forever, they'll be there. And they have
narrowboats there that you can actually wander through and have a look at and have a good chat with the boat builders about what buying a new narrowboat is all about. If you're interested in buying secondhand, they've got some boat brokerage there, for example, ABNB, who I both bought and sold my narrowboat through. And they'll talk you through the whole process of buying used and the pros and cons and what you need to watch out for and so on and so forth. And there was also a stand I did want to mention, the Accessible Waterways Association are there on E209. So if you've got any queries about whether it is feasible to go boating with an accessibility issue, I know they would be very, very happy to talk to you. Loads more than that to talk about if you're a fan of the fiberglass canal cruiser, as all the best people are these days, then Tyndean Marinas, who are not just a marina operator but have a finger in every pie of canal boating, they're the main dealer for Viking, who've been making fiberglass cruisers for, again, for decades, and they do both narrowbeam ones and widebeam cruisers as well. And there are river cruisers, so if going down the Thames is more your thing, there's all that, plus the aforementioned other boating aspects of the show. 15th to the 18th of February, I'm there, particularly on the Friday, for my talk at 1:45. Be very nice to see you there and hopefully putting some questions my way on the live stage. Go to the link in the description, check out the latest exhibitor list, and hopefully see you there. Another thing I want to start doing while I'm here is clearing the boat out a bit. There's a whole load of stuff in here that will get in the way of me doing any refurbishments. Trouble is, I haven't really got anywhere at home to put it. My shed is full of junk. It won't really go in the attic very well. So I don't really know what to do with it, but smaller items I will just clear and have to find a space for. Things like the wooden top bit that goes over the sink, I don't need that, really. There's a couple of deck chairs over here that don't need to be in here. There's what appears to be a bike lock, don't need that. Just a lot of stuff needs to be out of the way. Well, I've moved a load of stuff over there. I've pulled out the refueling containers, won't need them for a while. Got another bag of bits here. Plus random bits of wood. Now these look like they were something original to do with the boat, but I don't know what they are and they're a bit manky. There's a single deck chair, which I don't need, and this mat thing. Don't know what that's for. Plus some random bits of carpeting. None of which I need. All of which has freed up this rear berth, so I can finally have a look underneath it, see what's lurking underneath. Do I dare? Yes, I dare. This might get a bit dark. Let's see what's going on. Oh my goodness. More random stuff. And actually, that's a very soggy board. And look at all that scuzzy dirt. I'll give that a wipe down, just because I can't cope with it. Well, the haul includes a thing of multi-purpose rope, a random bit of wood, some so-called glass repair tape, various bits of metal, including a little box, an old fuse box, two very rusty spark plugs, and a thing you mount a fire extinguisher on, and what appears to be a fire blanket. What's slightly odd is that there is a bulkhead here, so there's obviously space under here, but no apparent way to get to it. And then similarly, there's a bulkhead here with no apparent way to get to whatever space is underneath it, and it goes back out there under there, which I don't, mind you, I've never tried actually getting in under there. Maybe there's a hole under there. Again, slightly alarmingly, there's a bit of water right up there, which was making the spark plugs very wet, which is why they're so rusty, and I don't know where that's come from. It could be condensation again. Okay, it is a little bit tidier in there now, and it looks like I need to do a trip to the tip to get rid of loads of stuff. It suddenly occurred to me I'd never actually lifted up the seat cushion on this side. So, ooh, another gallery of treats. What have we got? Something says repair kit. There's some pipe and, oh look, a random bit of wire. Which really is a random bit of wire entering in two naked ends, positive and negative. Let's not let them touch. And it goes there. What the heck? What we have is
an engine manual, but not for the engine that's actually on the boat. It's for a Suzuki, which must have been the one that was nicked on for a previous owner. We've got a fiberglass repair kit with some polymer and acetone and all the fiberglassy bits. We've got some water hose and an air pump for like bicycle tyres, a scoopy thing for scooping things up out of the canal, and a clue as to the wiring. Look, this is clearly a battery connector terminal, completely loose. So I wonder if this was the original location for the batteries, and these would have been the main feed off those batteries, because this quite clearly indicates that a chunky car type battery was under here. So I'm going to hazard a guess that this doesn't now do anything. I'm still not going to let the ends touch just in case, but I think that's redundant. And then space, the final frontier. Right, that side is now tidy as well. Disturbingly again, right in the bottom and along the edge, there's a tiny little trough in the boat hull, and there's water in there. Not a lot, just a tiny little amount, which again might well be the condensation of years gone by. However, for the moment, I'm just feeling pleased that I've tidied things up a bit. Unfortunately, it means I've got a load of stuff to take to the tip, which I wasn't planning on doing today. There is one other thing I am desperate to do before I do anything else, and that is get rid of the awful doors on these cupboards in the front cabin. I really do not like them. Oh, that's better. Oh my goodness, look how many holes there are in this fiberglass. Dear, oh dear. I'll probably end up having to cut that out and put new glass in or something. Perhaps. Anyway, that's one door. Well, that screw's not even in or holding anything. The screw's heads are shot, so they're no good. The doors are off. Of course, that does expose all the electrics, which are not pretty, but I didn't like the doors. They needed to go. Right, that's all I've got time for today. Yes, that's about all I can do today. I need to make a few trips to the car with all these bags of bits and random planks of wood and other stuff, and then I will go and dispose of them responsibly, obviously, and then come back next time and do something else. I've got a list. People said make a list. Well, I had already made a list, and it's a long and frightening list, but lots of little things to tick off. I'm just so pleased I've taken those doors off. I know it's a silly thing, but it's a start, isn't it? Got to do the little steps, and that's the first one underway. Anyway, thanks for watching. Cheerio.